Good morning. Welcome to First Congregational Church here in Union City, Michigan. What a pleasure it is to gather together on this day after Christmas. I hope that you realize as you have gone through the days with family and friends that this is a place where we hope that you are feeling welcomed, loved, cared for, and that this is a place where you know that no matter who you are, no matter where you are in life's journey, that you are welcome here. And we are glad to be sharing together in worship. And Mark will take over from here.
Good morning. My name is Mark Hageman. I'm the liturgist today. I hope that you find this church friendly and inspiring. I want everybody to bring their attention to the announcements in the bulletin. One additional announcement for the nominating committee, Shalom, in addition to the other boards that need somebody, has 4 openings. So if you're interested in being on Shalom, please get in contact with Diane Parkinson and she will forward you on to them. If you bought poinsettias, please take them with you. There are sleeves available to protect them. And there are additional announcements as well. There is childcare available after the children's chat. And I invite you all to coffee hour following the service. So at this time, we will have the ringing of the bell. Please join with me in the opening prayer. Creator God, you are worthy to be praised. You have created rulers of the earth and all peoples, young men and women alike, old and young together. You made them to be together in a good creation that provides for them a world covered in mountains and all hills, fruit and trees and cedars, wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds. All of life is connected by your design. We give you thanks for creating all of us invaluable.
Today. We have a couple little squiddles around, but Izzy can stay where she's at if, yeah. I know sometimes kids can feel put on the spot. I don't want to put them on the spot on the day after Christmas, but one of the things that I do want to talk a little bit about, hi Izzy, how you doing, is this scripture that Mark is about to read. You see, we don't get much time at all with baby Jesus. We get the Christmas day, and here it is, day after Christmas. Baby Jesus is one day old, and we start talking about Jesus in the temple at 12 years old. So 12 years have passed seemingly overnight, and we don't really have much to talk about for the days between day one and day 12. I mean, we do have a scene in Luke where after Jesus is 8 days old, they bring him to the temple, and Simeon takes him and sings a song about finally getting to see the baby Jesus in person. I know. And Izzy, you are the babyest person here today. I know, and you're still more than a year old, or about a year old, yeah. She's a year and a half old, yeah. And we don't get any scenes of Jesus at that age. Or how old is
Mason
is five. We don't get anything about Jesus at 5 years old. And so what we have to do is we have to remember to look at you, because you teach us when we look at a five-year-old and when we look at a year-and-a-half-old. They teach us grown-ups about what Jesus must have been like when he was a baby, when he was an infant, when he was a toddler, when he was a kindergartner. That's where we learn about how Jesus impacted the world, because as he went through those stages, he gave us images of himself that we can learn from, and we can learn from each other. So I want to give thanks for you, Izzy, today, and you, Mason, for being with us in church and helping us to feel Macy. I heard wrong from this ear, Mark. But that's okay. I should have turned this ear to you so I could hear. And it's hard when my last name is Mason and somebody says Macy. I hear Mason right away. That's the first thing I hear. All right. And then the other ages of children that we've got here, my children. So let's pray. Do you want to pray with me? Should we pray together? Dear God, we thank you that you came to us as a baby. Which means you must have been two. And five, and ten, and 20, before we met you as a grown-up. Help us at all times to see you in each other. Amen.
Thank you.
Our scripture reading for today comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 41 through 52. Now every year his parents went to Jerusalem for the festival of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up as usual for the festival. When the festival was ended and they started to return, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Assuming that he was in the group of travelers, they went a day's journey. Then they started to look for him among their relatives and friends. When they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem to search for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them, and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished, and his mother said to him, "Child, why have you treated us like this? Look, your father and I have been searching for you in great anxiety." He said to them, "Why were you searching for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. Then he went down with them and came to Nazareth, and was obedient to them. His mother treasured all these things in her heart, and Jesus increased in wisdom and in years and in divine and human favor. The word of God for the people of God. At this time, because everybody loves hearing my voice, we're going to do the Christmas carol sing, and I will ask for anybody who would like to sing a Christmas carol to say it, and we will sing the first verse of that carol. Unless it's very short, we may do two then, but it has to be very short. So if you have one, just say it, and I'll say it so that the people online can hear what we're going to sing, and we'll try to catch the page number in the hymnal so that everybody knows where to go. So if you have a Christmas carol, go ahead and say it.
Come all ye faithful.
Oh, come all ye faithful.
148.
Angels, we have heard on high 155.
Manger, 147.
Thank you.
162, What Child Is This? Joy to the world.
Thank you. think everybody's played out or sung out.
Thank you, Mark and Amber. That gave me a chance to sit with my family and sing Christmas Carol, something we haven't done for a while. So appreciate that very, very much. One of the things I realized I didn't include today in the bulletin is an invitation to generosity. But I know that that in this Christmas season, we all recognize that there's opportunities for generosity every day. And so just a brief couple of words about that, because when Jesus' parents didn't know where he was, he, you know, vexed his mother, which teenage and preteen boys have been doing for generations now. But he said, "Didn't you know where to look for me?" And we've come here looking for Jesus in this sanctuary. And I think we need to be diligent in our search for Christ Jesus, because you know that Christ is attending to our holy parents' interests. Christ is attending to the needs of those old and young, the needs of those suffering malnutrition and maltreatment. Christ has come to attend to the interests of all of creation, and we continue to suffer. Our world is suffering, so we need to align our hearts with Christ our Redeemer. We need to give our hearts and pocketbooks to relieve the pressure of the suffering world, and continuing to proclaim the good news, which is that Christ came into the world to bring peace by expecting the best of creation. And one of the ways that we do that is by giving generously. And so I invite you to be generous with your gifts, either here in person or online. You can give through Tithely, you can mail a check to the church, or you can sponsor a nonprofit very near your home, because everybody in the nonprofit world needs our generosity these days. So be generous with your Christmas season. And now Jordan's going to play. Go tell it on the mountain. Thank you. That doesn't make you want to tap your foot. I don't know. I don't know where you walked in from, but man, thank you, Jordan. As we turn to God in prayer, I was just looking at some of the prayers that are printed out in the bulletin and realizing that we have a lot to pray for, and we have a lot of people in our lives that are in need, and we have a lot of people in the world that we don't even know who can receive our prayers and benefit from our prayers. So I hope that you take the time today to pray, not just now during church, but also this evening before you go to bed, tomorrow morning when you get up, because we need to be constant in the prayers that we have for other people and for ourselves. During our prayers this morning, I will take a moment of quiet in which you can call out the names of persons for whom you're praying. God knows why we're praying. God knows who we're praying for. And oftentimes God gives us names of people in our moments of silence to share. So I invite you to share those names if you will. You can also share those names in the quiet of your heart, and you can pray all you want about their condition when you lift them up. And we will pray with assurance, knowing that God is attending to our prayers and knowing that our prayers make a difference in our own lives and in the lives of the people for whom we pray. So, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Gracious God, our hearts are filled with the joy of Christmas. For in this Christmas season, we have once again been reminded to notice the presence of the Christ child in our midst. The Christ child that walks among us. The Christ child that inspires our hearts. The Christ child that loves us more than we can ever love ourselves. And then asks us to share that love with each other and the world. You hear our prayers, gracious God, and you answer them. So we ask that you would grant safe passage to all those persons who are traveling this day and the week to come, that they may find their way to their homes and families, and then find their way all the other places they're seeking to go these days. We know that we need to take an extra measure of protection against the pandemic that surrounds us. And so, gracious God, we ask that the vaccinations be as effective as possible, that social distancing and masking continue as needed, that we continue to embrace each other both in person and virtually in the safest possible ways, so that we can come through the opposite end of this condition better off, stronger and smarter and wiser and more complete as people. Share your truth with us, gracious God, that our hearts may be filled with knowledge and love. Share your strength with us, gracious God, that we can face each coming moment and overcome the challenges that meet us in those times. And now hear us, gracious God, in the quiet of this moment as we offer up our particular prayers for those whose names we know. thanks for Izzy's voice, for the prayer she offers. Give you thanks for all who are here in your presence today, and all who are scattered. For you grant us your peace, your love, your joy, your hope, your truth. And then you send us forth to serve you in so many different ways. Guide us into this new year to come, that 2022 will be a year in which we find all the answers we've been looking for. And we move toward you with purpose, integrity, and understanding. In Jesus' name we pray this. For he taught us that we can pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Now go forth And whatever you do, do it according to the heart of Jesus, our sovereign. Teach children and let children teach you. Cultivate wisdom and gratitude and mend the earth in the name of the triune God. Amen. Go in peace.